Humanity and dinosaurs were never intended to be this close to one another. San Diego deserved better. So too did the dinosaurs. But human beings, well, they're predictable, curious, greedy. These intruders caused more chaos than anyone could have imagined. In the time we'd been away, people had gone from caretakers to threat. Simon Masrani wanted to realize John Hammond's vision. Bigger, grander, more ambitious than the original. But dinosaurs have their own ambitions. To hunt, to feed, to carve out their niche in this strange new world. Let's see how things play out when we add you to the mix. Try not to get in their way, or you might be destined to repeat the past.
Repeat the past. He's very dramatic, as Mr. Ian Malcolm. Oh, hi. Yeah, I'm best in slot. And we're playing Isla Sorna Side B, i.e. the Jurassic Park 3 Chaos Theory.
So this is where all the excitement happened.
Yes, this is the place.
Simply amazing. And here, we will do it again. In addition to capturing the dinosaurs, which will serve as our foundation, I purchased InGen because I believe in the science. You can reproduce your results, can't you, Dr. Wu?
Of course I can do it. But it's going to take considerable effort and resources to get the science back to where it was.
And you will be well compensated for your efforts. Of course, I demand results.
And you will have them.
It's nice that those two are getting along.
I trust you've settled in and are ready to get started. This is Lily Halford, and she's coordinating operations. Miss Halford?
Thank you, Mr. Masrani. I think I speak for everyone here when I say we are very grateful for this opportunity you've given us.
As a boy, I loved to play with toy animals. And now, with this island and the dinosaurs, I have the greatest toy set imaginable. I want that joy, that excitement I had as a child. I want it to be felt by everyone. You will make that happen.
We'll need to start by getting a control center and response facility online. They'll all require power. This will give us a strong foundation.
And then, dinosaurs.
That is the plan.
This is my investment in the vision and in my people. Please, don't let me get in the way.
Okay, so I've never done this before, I've never seen this before. This is actually all brand new to me. All I know is that it's kind of a one and done kind of thing. It's like a half an hour, 40 minutes kind of thing. That is about the only information I have on the Chaos Theory for this. Oh, hello, Bracky. Oh, I can't get to you. Maybe I can later on. Something over there. What's that over there? I'll hack my way of... Oh, it's Corythosaurus. Makes a lot of sense. Corythosaurus, Gallimimus, should be some parasaurs in there as well. And I know there's some stuff around the map. So I spotted the airstrip here before. We actually talked about this already on the map preview. Obviously, this is the airstrip where all the many bad things happen. You can actually see some of the wreckage of the plane right there. It should actually be in the trees, but it's cooler that you can see it because obviously you wouldn't see it in the forest. So we've got the plane there. We've got the airstrip where Eric went on, basically, and yes, and knocked over stuff that has hurt my throat. And I saw a little something over there. Is that the little worker village research area that they went to? Yeah, I think where, you know, where we had the, I assume this is what it's meant to be, where, you know, where the raptor was hiding behind. It was a dumb scene, to be honest, where they got attacked by the raptors for the first time. The raptor was hiding behind the vat kind of thing. I'm assuming that's what that's meant to be. And I've heard, although I don't see it yet, that somewhere out there is meant to be the parachute, the red and white parachute from Eric Kirby and the heroic. Oh, there's the aviary as well. Cool. Hello, buddy. Don't have your bloody pterosaurs in the game, do you? Although it's worth mentioning, I know people are angry that the lack of Jurassic Park 3 Pteranodon, myself included, well, angry is not the right word, but Frontier have said they're looking into it. I do believe it's a mistake. I think they are actually meant to be in the game And they're only not because of an error someone's made or just, you know, something that happened along the line. So I know they posted on Twitter, and I retweeted it if you want to check my Twitter, that it will be in the game. I'm looking for this parachute. Where is it? I want to see it. We'll carry on playing and we'll keep an eye out for it. Ah, there it is. You see anything? Yeah, not yet, as he says. And then Ben Hildebrand. It's a shame there's no corpse hanging from the parachute, as there would be. But I can kind of see why not. Anyways, I think that's probably it for the map. So, got 6 minutes already. Let's get started. We need a control center. Let's get nice and tippy-tappy like so. And we need a response facility. I am curious about this. I also have questions. We've talked about this one briefly in the past, because I'm aware of sort of the general storyline. Unfortunately, it's not necessarily that easy to avoid spoilers. I think we're going to get Kirby today. Let's get Kirby today. Kirby like Ben Kirby. Ben Kirby? Kirby like Paul Kirby. Ben Hildebrand, Paul Kirby. There you go. What was I going to say? I was going to say something cool and fun. I can't remember what it was. Chop chop you. Oh yeah, we need a... backup generator. The most evil device the world has ever seen, this thing right here. Okay, thank you very much. Capture and enclose the wild Ankylosaurus.
The Ankylosaurus. Lovely creature. Capture it and then secure it in an enclosure.
Obviously, we have to do this manually, right? We'd have not to. Do 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 do. Do, 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 do. I was not going to use lock-on, because lock-on's for nerds. Here we go! Alright, long-range shot. You ready, folks? You ready? Huh. Oh yeah, nothing but net, baby! Quite proud of myself, actually. Oh yeah, I got my... Oh, no, it wasn't enough. There's an achievement. You have to shoot a dinosaur manually with the tranquilizer from, like... I don't know, 125 yards away, I think it is. I don't know if it's yards or meters or whatever, but it's 125. That was not far enough. That was 109. So hopefully, at some point, we have to get ourselves the Brachiosaurus, because I suspect the Brachiosaurus will be easier to do than, say, a Gallimimus. I don't know. There's also an achievement I've seen. I don't know that I care much about the achievements, but it's fun to do a little extra thing. There's one to shoot a Pteranodon, or a pterosaur, I should say, in general, out of the air, which is pretty cool. Alright, come here, buddy. I wonder if I have to set everything up. Yeah, we probably do, right? We have to actually just build a full-on little facility, although I can't get a ranger outpost quite yet. Give it a little bit of water. Cut that sneeze out of the video. Good stuff. Sure. And cut into there a little bit as well. And I don't know what the Anki actually eats. Let's get it sent over here. Lickety split. Really, it's taking its time. It's very cool that those details are there, though. So this one actually has more little bits of information. One, two, three. We've got four hints as to the film itself, which I think is pretty nice. That's more than all the others so far. Jurassic Park had one. The Lost World had two. This has four. Which makes sense, because Jurassic Park 3 is the best film.
While this is a team effort, I'm sure you understand that my vision carries some weight. With that said, I want a ranger post constructed, and then a team assigned to it. From there, they can perform status checks on the animals.
I'm gonna do it myself, thank you very much. I'm all hands on today. I've got to say, not my favourite of the voice actors in the game. I don't mind the Hammond, but the Masrani is a little bit... Oh no! Bobies, get out of there, Bobies!
Is your Ankylosaurus happy? The best way to find out is to monitor their comfort level and increase it as necessary.
There you go. Let's get some ground leaf. Bam! Bam! It's not bamming as much as I'd like. Some fruit. There you go, tons of the stuff. Bloody tons of the stuff. Nice lush environment for... Oh, it is a pretty cool looking Anki, it really is. Although the red... the colours I'm not in love with necessarily. These colours, very cool. Yeah, I do love it. And that's part of my Jeep. Lovely stuff. Oh, it's not a Jeep anymore.
Orson Welles once said, this was about a movie studio, he said that it was the biggest electric train set a boy ever had. Of course, he never had dinosaurs. I want to make sure we can see and monitor the Ankylosaurus. Build a viewing platform, will you? I realize that may have sounded like a suggestion, but I know you understand.
All right, Master Ronnie, no need. No need for the attitude. The interesting thing is, that viewing platform is different than the one in the main game. The circle is much, much closer than it is in Jurassic Park. I wonder if the Jurassic World one is close and the Jurassic Park one is further away. That's interesting. I've never really thought to check that. Interesting. Hello, buddy. How you living? Living large and in charge? Yeah, you are. I may as well spend some time with you for 20 seconds, I suppose. Oh, you know what we need? We need a blim-blammin' letterbox. Need a blim. I can't do anything. There we go. Well, I spent all my time doing that, but still. Yeah, letterbox.
We need to move these animals to the holding facility off-site. Once their enclosure is ready, we can bring them to Jurassic World.
So really, I mean, what did I achieve doing this? I don't know what I actually did. Oh, buddy, you're gonna have a concussion in the morning. See ya, pal. Miss you. So you look like you're on fire and it's green and that's cool. Look at the flare. The flares have got even better with this. It starts off hyper green and then the colour kind of gradients outwards. As you can see, it gets like smoky colour at the end. That's really nice little detail there. That wasn't in the last game, I don't think. That's actually pretty awesome. I like that. Off you go, pal. Ooh, the plate did a little shift there. That was painful looking. Arrivederci. We are one now. So, oh, look at that. Look at that. The Ankylosaurus ruins it a little bit, but the lighting, man. Absolutely sublime.
I hope you're ready for some excitement. I certainly am. Today, we need to capture several dinosaurs of the same species and get them back under our control. Captive and in an enclosure. I'm ready when you are.
Right. You ready? We're getting this achievement right now. Oh, that's gotta be it. Yes, got it. No problem. Right, sweet. Now I'm gonna get a little closer, because that's madness. You know what I want? It's like a little spotlight. I think that'd be really cool. Like, that hangs down here. Pew! So I can actually see what the hell I'm doing, for one. Also, I just think it would look more dramatic. It'd be like the helicopter at the start of Fallen Kingdom, you know? You know what? I hit it from a billion miles away, and I can't hit it in the slightest. Come on! Seriously? Come here. Come here. I'm trying to predict where they go, but the Stego doesn't move. Oh my god, there we go. One down. It's in there somewhere. I'm really surprised I didn't hit it more, though. There we go. Right. They're next two. Just all in slightly awkward positions, it must be said. Oh, you're okay, though. Okay, good stuff. And number four is there, you hello, JK. Where have you gone? Let me at him. Let me at him. Oh, there's a way. It's actually serpentining. It is legitimately serpentining right now. Cheeky little blighter. It's in there somewhere. I did not come out of that looking particularly skillful, it must be said. I am, but it doesn't look like it. I think we're going to have to make this exhibit a little bit bigger. A little bit on the teeny tiny side. To say the least. I mean, it's fine for the Anki, but for four Stegos, not so sure on that one. That's probably fine. Obviously, we'll have to change some of the innards as well. Let's just do that. Take advantage of all the room available. There we go. Right, good stuff. Good stuff. So yeah, what we're doing is... I mean, I'm assuming this is meant to... Even though the DPG stuff isn't canon anymore... I assume this is meant to reference what did happen in the DPG, which was that Masrani bought out InGen, and then they went and they got all the dinosaurs from Isla Sorna, and they brought them over to Isla Nublar, and that's kind of how they got started for Jurassic World, basically. My question... Wait, what? How did I lose two? Wait, I had 3 out of 4, and now I'm down to 2 out of 4. What? Game. Not sure about this one. I'm just gonna... Maybe that'll work. They're pretty bloody enclosed, game. Game. There we go! Wait, give it a sec. Alright, it's fine now. That was a very weird little bug. I've not had that before.
Let's crack on with these next tasks then, shall we?
Why have you been knocked out?
You're responsible for performing status checks and increasing the dinosaur's welfare. Should be straightforward, and I know you're up to the job.
So what you're seeing there is actually something I only just learned about very, very recently. And that is if you assign a helicopter to a ranger post like this one here. Again, I feel like this is something the game never says, but maybe it does, I don't know. Anyways, if you assign a helicopter to a ranger post, as I just did, whenever a dinosaur threatens to break out, as in, you know, your raptors on other maps, for example, for a good example, the helicopter, like, automatically comes along and takes them out, basically. Do people know that? I barely knew that. Like, I only just learned that was a thing, so... It's brand new information for me. I think it's pretty useful. I'm going to use that in my other playthroughs. Should be good. Alright, they're not all fine, are they? No, but this one, for God's sake. Come on, you! There we go. kids these days. Kids, stegosauruses. Both... A pain, what can you say?
I love keeping an eye on my dinosaurs, but I just don't have the time to do so as much as I'd like. That's why I have you. Be my eyes and monitor these animals.
Will do, buddy. Will do.
These dinosaurs are ready to move to the holding facility. Let's not keep them or me waiting.
So what are we achieving? That's my main question. I guess it's kind of like observe the dinosaurs, check if there's any problems, you know, maybe there's medical issues, maybe there's something else. You know, there's little problems that have to be fixed before we can send the dinosaurs over to Jurassic World. It's kind of treating this island like it was meant to be, like Site B was the factory floor for Jurassic Park, essentially. It isn't a what-if, though. This is what happened in DPG canon, at the very least. DPG isn't canon, but that's neither here nor there. It seems a bit weird to kind of stick to it, but maybe something else will happen. Who knows? Who blim-blummin' knows? It's a beautiful new day, you and Isla Sorna. Always happy to be on Isla Sorna, frankly. Oh, my hands are killing me, though. Oh. Spent the day painting the roof. I say, I suppose, ceiling is a better word for it. Off you go, chaps. Chapesses. Oh, you've been breeding in the wild, haven't you? So chap... What's... Is a gender-neutral chap? I'm gonna call you Chapo. There you go. Lovely stuff like that. Oh, interesting that these trees move with the helicopters and these ones don't, like the paleo foliage.
There's a new dinosaur out in the wild. Track the animal and capture it so we can bring it back into the fold.
Da 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 So yeah, hitting all the dinosaurs relevant to Isla Sorna so far. Ankylosaurus was in Jurassic Park 3, Stegosaurus was big in Jurassic Park 2, Spinosaurus obviously had its little... I mean, I say big, Ankylosaurus had one very small scene in Jurassic Park 3. Spinosaurus obviously had its single... Ah, stunning. Had its single jokey scene in Jurassic Park 3. And nothing but the, whatchamacallit? Humor boy. The comic relief, there we go. Humor boy is not the term I was looking for. Ceratosaurus is nothing but the comic relief. How do you feel about that, Cerato? Where are you? You're not a Ceratosaurus. You're my fly girls. Wish that's a lad. There it is. No, I need the... Oh, what's the Rider of Valkyries? I can't remember the music. It would have been perfect. It's so dramatic looking. Oh, it's a flower. It's just very blue. I was very curious. Hey, buddy. Are you relatively happy? 82. We've created dinosaurs. Come on, Bobies.
We have them on display and for science. But that means we need to monitor our flock. I want status checks routinely performed on all of our dinosaurs. This is how we maintain our advantage.
With no explanation of what that actually means. It's typical corporate leader, honestly. Just tells you to do something, says blah blah blah.
This dinosaur isn't responding as we'd hoped. It'll need the resources that are available at our paleo medical facility.
Okay, do I need to build a science center? Crazy town. Requiring so much from me already. I'm surprised he hasn't said synergy or synastic or connectitude or something like that, you know? And it's nice little cheeky. It's nice using these. I've not used the Jurassic World buildings in ages, really, so it's cool to, you know, get some science in there. Love a bit of science. Right, let's grab this paleo medical structure. Here we got, Lee. What's Lee into? Let's find out. Verity took a maths degree before focusing on their love of dinosaurs. Verity formed a paleontology club for fellow dinosaur fans at school. Amateur photographer Verity enjoys taking shots of major cities, and she's dirt cheap. Good job, Verity. Proud of you. I'm in pain. Come on, Verity, smash it. There she goes. Absolute monster of a woman, Verity. Absolute monster of a woman. I do mean that in the best way possible. Which is pretty possible. Right. There's never any rhyme or reason to these management. They kind of just end up... It's actually pretty realistic in that if you don't plan it out from the start, it kind of ends up like an urban sprawl, you know? Now, you need to be renamed. You are the Fixer. And direct control. And direct control. Why not? We know it's short, so let's have some fun with it and be a bit daft. This is apparently my definition of being a bit daft. I'm a kook, what can I say? I'm a crazy child. A wild child. This woman has massive legs. I like to imagine she's standing at the bottom of the van. Because that would make me happy. Ah.
The thrill of the hunt without the guilt of the kill. That's our mission. Tranquilize this dinosaur, and then we'll get it the best treatment my money can buy at the Paleo Medical Facility.
Poof. What have you done, buddy? What's happened to you? Combat? Who have you been fighting with? You numpty. Alright, come on, fly girls. You're messing this up. I'm going to do everything myself. Oh, never mind. Can we just pretend I did that myself? Let's do that. Okay, so you can send it over beforehand. Obviously, we need to get ourselves another scientist. And we need wealth. Oh, we can get loads. Okay, sweet. Whoa! Logistics skills. Generalist in this kind of scenario is actually really good, so we're going to grab that. As big as I'm usually not on logistics. Let's grab some logistics as well. Let's grab. Sure. We'll see what we need later on. Okay, so. You're not here yet, are you? Is this looking a little different to me? Yeah, I think the Jurassic Park one doesn't have the high walls around the outside. Maybe because in Jurassic World they were more... I mean, they still had to look after a T-Rex in Jurassic Park, though, so... Kind of curious as to why. Why are the massive walls here, but not on the Jurassic Park version? Or maybe it's not the Jurassic Park version I'm thinking of. It might be the research one from the campaign, actually. Interesting. Get you all cured up. Robots, activate! Do robot things. Just spray the dinosaur. I like to think it's not even anything special. It's not a special material or liquid of any form. It's just water, really. Just hose it down. It's like a Free Willy kind of situation where you have to moisten it every now and again to keep it happy. There are so many jokes in that sentence. So many! Come on, buddy. Spray your fracture clear. Lovely stuff. And we might need another viewing tower at this rate, actually. I guess there's no reason not to, is there, technically?
Now that we have the dinosaur back home, why don't we make it feel like a real home? Watch the ratings and get the enclosure all comfy.
Will do. Like that she said, I like Lily. Lily seems like a nice character, you know? She's pretty chill. She hasn't revealed herself to be an evil megalomaniac like the others quite yet, anyway. Getting funky here. I mean, she might well be an evil megalomaniac, I don't know, but... She hasn't revealed herself to be one. I suppose they tend to not, originally. Dua seemed pretty chill originally in Jurassic World Evolution. She turned out to be insane, so...
It's time to move the dinosaurs. Next stop, our holding facility.
Locking and loading. I am the Fly Girls. Wait, I need to do a... I have to do my mobile. I'm the Fly Girl. Wait. I'm the Fly Girls. Beautiful stuff. All right. Very proud of myself. I can't do it. I'm really bad with like accents and voices and all that. The only thing I can do is a little bit of Irish, but that's because I am a little bit of Irish. As in, my dad is Irish. And... That might be it, actually. I used to impersonate Chris Tarrant, who is the... I don't know, and if you're outside the UK, know who Chris Tarrant is, but he's most known for presenting Who Wants to Be a Millionaire. And when I was a young, obnoxious child, I used to ring people up and pretend I was Chris Tarrant and say that I had Bob on on Who Wants to Be a Millionaire. Because everyone has a friend called Bob, apparently, and it worked half the time, so...
Asset in transit.
Oh, it's a Spinosaurus.
Shouldn't we intervene?
This is instinctual behavior. Unfortunate, but not unanticipated.
Why is this happening at nighttime?
How would we?
Survival of the fittest at its most primitive, its most prehistoric. We are witnessing history in action.
Oh, I can't watch.
And I can't turn away.
No.
I'll send a team to collect what we can before the scavengers pick over the carcass.
Collect the body. I have plans for it.
So not keep making the noise. I don't know if you heard that. Obviously there's a thing in the game where something can swallow a phone. And that is like an ailment that they get. And you'll hear the ringtone through the dinosaur. But that had the proper ringtone. I only heard it very briefly. Oh, I can't believe it's nighttime. That's really annoying, actually. I would have much preferred to see that in the day. I mean, that's a what-if, right? This is... I mean, is it, though? It kind of is, because... Okay, that is the what-if, but oh, I don't know if they expected it to be one. Because I think the suggestion is that the skeleton on Main Street is meant to be the Spinosaurus from Jurassic Park 3. However, I don't really want to talk about it in case of spoilers, but obviously there have been revelations lately that maybe that Spinosaurus is still alive, thanks to other things... So, I guess this would be alternate history in that, you know, the Spinosaurus is dead instead, essentially. And it has to be the same Spinosaurus as the one... This has to be the film one, because obviously we just heard the Kirby Paint Hotel plus Well, it's not the Kirby Painted Tile Plus, is it? It's the other one.
We're expanding our reach throughout the island. This means more opportunities to capture more dinosaurs.
I'm specifically in need of a Triceratops. My team will need to monitor it, and then we can transfer it off the island as we've done before.
I'm making myself look like a bit of a fake fan here, but... That isn't the Kirby Paint and Tile Plus one that the Spinosaurus would have eaten. Is it? Isn't the... Isn't that the... No, wait, no, I'm wrong. It is, never mind. But it's not Kirby Paint and Tile Plus. In Westgate, hello. I'm thinking it's the one from the, you know, from the boat? Wait, no, that's the same phone, though. That is the same phone. There's only one phone. Ignore me. Hello, raptors! Anyways, yeah. No, right, I've just made myself look like a JP3 fake fan, when I'm very much not. I adore that film from the bottom of my heart. I was kind of joking when I said it's the best of the bunch, but it is my third favourite. It actually might be my second favourite, unironically. Kirby Paint and Tile Plus in Westgate. Let's go! I wonder what happens if you run out of fuel mid-flight, you know? Like, if I run out of fuel right now, do I just tumble to the earth? Do we do a Maserati from the film? I suppose we need some pterosaurs. And then Dominus Rex. That's a lot of Triceratopses! You only want that? There's so many of them! Oh yeah, I need to hit it twice. Whoopsie daisy. Oh, you have no defensive qualities at all, do you, buddy? Alright, apparently we only need one. Off you pop! That's what they hear when they're going to the fecal matter. God, I feel bad for myself. I'm covered in paint, though, so that's my excuse. Because I have this thing, right, I'm going to talk about this while we wait for this to get delivered. I'll make it pretty, there you go. I'm painting the ceiling in the... We've got like this back room that opens up into the garden, and I was painting the ceiling. And annoyingly, I am just about tall enough to paint the ceiling without needing a ladder. But I'm not quite tall enough to do it at like a comfortable angle. So not only do I hurt myself eventually, but as I'm painting and the flecks of paint are falling on me, because I'm inevitably right underneath it, I get covered in little flecks of paint. If I was a little bit shorter, I'd use the ladder. I mean, I could still use the ladder, but because I don't have to, I don't. The mind is a funny thing. What can I say? How are we doing on fuel? Oh, maybe it doesn't... Maybe it doesn't drain it if you fly yourself. There you go. Top money-saving tip. Fly yourself so you don't drain yourself. Tell your friends. Tell your family. Come on, Trico. My beautiful beloved. What skin is it using? Is it using the 1993? Yeah. Yeah, it looks like it. I know. It's okay. For God's sake. It just got here. Oh, God. Up we go again. Right, no, I'm not allowed to move. We have to do it from here. I have to add some intrigue to the level if I can. Come on. That hit, right? Oh, come off it. Come on. Hit. Man, the fly girls are really messing this up. There we go. I've had several that to me look like they hit, if I'm honest. Obviously they didn't, and I'm wrong, and I'm bad, but that's neither here nor there. Come on! I've been playing a lot of Halo Infinite lately. Because Halo Infinite is so good, by the way. I can just put that out there. Halo Infinite is amazing. And I need to train my sniper skills. I'm much more of a close combat kind of guy. I feel like I've committed to this really stupid idea. It feels like it has to be committed to. I can shuffle a little bit on the helipad. Over that, it's in the most annoying position. It's there. Come on, beautiful. Hit. Come on. Fine. I'm just trying to mix things up, you know? Boy howdy, I'm not coming out of this looking good. Thanks. There we go! Oh, so much skill on display, it's crazy! You guys must be blown away right now. The best shot I ever did was taking down that bloody Allosaurus in my preview footage. It's all been downhill since then, honestly. Both in Evolution 2 and in my life, so. As they say in the clubs.
I don't expect results. I demand them. I realize we are dealing with time measured in tens of millions of years. But that is for the dinosaurs, not us. We move quickly. Our time, my friends, is limited. Let's get motivated.
Let's get physical. Physical. Wanna get physical. What is that over there? In the water. Is it a Pachycephalosaurus? It looks like one. Right. So many trikes. It's a little bit like the game trail. Pachycephalosaurus, Parasaurolophus. No one mentioned you, but. How many do we need? Four. Nice. Come on, buddy. Come on. It's just gonna make it more difficult on both of us. Where are you going? What are you doing? What are you. Come here. Come here. Come here. Stay. You know what, Fly Girls, I've misjudged you. This is hard. Dinosaurs move a lot. I really thought it was gonna run quicker than that. Cheeky little blighter. No, I didn't even want that one. I wanted this one. Go right, I'm gonna. I don't know what I'm going to do. We'll keep on going. I don't know if that was four or three, it must be said. Five galley. I think I've got all six galleys. I think I need one para and the brachies. By the looks of things. Come on. Yeah? Oh. Oh no! Oh no, it died! Wait, do I have to redo the whole thing? Wait, where's my checkpoint? Oh no, I messed up! Oh no! It's because I'm doing it manually. This would be so much easier if I wasn't. Oh no! Oh no! Okay, we're okay. I'll skip forward a little bit, folks, because for the sake of your sanity, really. Okay, the paras and the galleys have been sorted. So we're gonna go head off and try to find these brachies, which I believe are right down here at the far end. We will ignore the disaster I've had so far on what is essentially an incredibly easy mission. But I'm just mixing things up. Yeah, I've got to keep things spicy for you folks at home. What can I say? Where are these brachies? Oh, where are these brachies? Actually pretty unsure. Actually don't know. Okay, that's the parador. Oh, wait, no, it's Momenchi. This way? I'm gonna fly over the mountain. I'm full of confidence that this is going to work. It is actually working. Okay, sweet. I really need to remember Ride of the Valkyries. It's a good opportunity to get your, well, if you're not me. How did that not hit? For God's sake! Fine, I'll just do it like a normal person. Whatever. Didn't want to be cool anyway. Being cool is for nerds. How many hits are you gonna take? Three? Yeah, you're a big boy. Maybe two. Oh, maybe four. Maybe three. Yeah, not four is what I mean. One. Let's try it out. Maybe three will do it. Let's find out. So, a little bit of science. Three. Stop shooting this one in the meantime. Stop missing this one in the meantime. think it might be four, actually. What are you on?
Yeah.
You're a toughie. I'll give you that much. The shame. Okay, all the way back here. Can I not just, in theory, I suppose it's a wild area, they're not going to let me do that. I was hoping I could just maybe just build an enclosure around it. Kind of like what you did in Isla Sauna on Jurassic World, where what I would do personally is just build around the Stegosauruses wherever on Earth they were, and later on that would become a Stegosaurus habitat, essentially. Instead of shuffling, I think it was like there was a Spinosaurus, and then there was like 22 Stegosaurus or something like that. It was madness. They've handled that kind of thing a lot better this time around, it must be said. This enclosure's not going to be big enough. Three brachies? They're going to need loads of room. Asset in transit. Asset transportation underway. And probably some more forests. There we go. We'll see. We shall see. If we need to make it bigger that way, that's easy to do as well. A beautiful habitat, forged by the gods of architecture, I'm sure you'll agree. How are my parrots? We need some ground nut. Gotta make them happy. Asset transported. There we go, happy parrots. Happy shroofies. Not shroofies, galleys. Oh, they're lonely. We need some ground leaf as well. Go. Can't do anything about the loneliness. Wait, where am I ever? Wait. Hello? For God's sake. Keep leaving dinosaurs to die. I'm not even doing it on purpose. I thought I had the ball. I counted and they were all. Come on. Come on, game. I know it's in there. No! Come on. Where are you, buddy? I'll get you out of here, pal. There we go. Get you sorted, nice and happy. Brachiosaurus, how are we doing? Let's go find out. Bobies, do your thing. Oh, it is kind of cool. It's grown on me a little bit over time, the JP3 one. I really appreciate, I mean, JP3 obviously had some of the best dinosaur designs in the entire franchise. The Spinosaurus is top notch, the Velociraptors are as good as they ever were. The Pteranodon is fantastic. The Compies were already in two. I don't like the Corythosaurus. I don't love the Parasaur. The Ceratosaurus is really good. The Ankylosaurus is okay. Brachiosaurus is growing on me. At least it's kind of the same as it is with a lot of them. At least it's got like color and interesting design, you know? They kind of like tried something with it, which I appreciate a lot. How much tall knot do you need? Bloody Nora. Right, this is ridiculous levels of tall knot here. No one in the world needs that much tall knot. Nobody has ever needed that much tall knot in the history of the world. I'm going to let it just spread out this territory a little bit more as well. Got all this room over here that's not using. Transportation complete. Assume you want them all nice and happy. If you make me send all these off-site, game, I swear to God. Has that happened again? One Gallimimus, two, three, four, five, six. I have six Gallimimus. What are you want about, game? There's six of them. What are you talking about? This is all I can think to do. It worked last time, it's gonna work again. There we see, it's foolproof. Yeah, okay. Well, let's just sort it for the galleys. Yeah, so just Brachy's gonna be a bit of a problem, but we'll fix that.
This is an across-the-board objective. Every dinosaur, every species, we want to increase their comfort rating. In fact, we're the only ones that should feel any discomfort. Well, truth be told, you, actually.
Sorted. Right, Fly Girls, I'm not doing it again. I'm not.
We're moving all the animals to our holding facility. This will be a huge undertaking. So I'm expecting nothing less than your best. And you're going to give it to me.
All right, Master Ronnie, calm down. Buy me a drink. I'm going to buy another responsibility. We're going to speed this up my own way. Speed. Power.
Acknowledging asset collection request.
This reminds me quite a lot of Clair's Sanctuary, in a way, I suppose. Be the closest comparison in the last game.
Asset.
Gotta say, the drive, the Fly Girls are living up to their name. They're doing well. Doing some good work here today. More than I can say for myself, quite frankly. And if we go over here and hit it, there we go. Capture scene 2. You don't get a fancy name, I'm afraid.
Asset has been collected.
It's like a race. The Great Race, but with tranquilizing dinosaurs. Dum-dum. Oh, look at that. Synchronized Brachy. Tranquilizing. If that isn't the dream, I don't know what is. Turn. Another one over there. You go grab that. Thank you very much. I gotta say, the Fly Girls brought the raid game there. They did the Brachy and then they bought five more dinosaurs in like no time at all? That was pretty impressive. Oh, yeah. There's always one who gets away at the end. Okay, I think that's all of them. That's looking pretty good to me.
Transporting asset. Asset being transported.
It's interesting though, because we never saw JP3 Paras, we never saw JP3 Brachys or JP3 Ankys or anything like that in Jurassic World. It was always the Jurassic Park style or indeed Jurassic... Did I not shift you out? Or indeed Jurassic World style. There's never... It felt like Jurassic Park 3 was kind of abandoned for a long time, in a way. I think maybe they're realizing that it holds a special place in a lot of our hearts. It might be a ridiculous film, and it is, but it's also a really cool film in its own way. Yeah, we're done. Wow.
A sight to behold, Dr. Wu.
When I left Isla Nublar last time, I never thought I'd return. And certainly never thought I'd rebuild Jurassic Park.
Oh, but you haven't. You've helped me create something even better, bigger, more ambitious, and more financially viable. Dinosaurs for the masses. Anyone can create a park, but it takes genius to create a world.
What is that line? Utter nonsense. Oh, the writing has not improved. I was going to say, how is that more difficult than either of the other two? These are all wrong, by the way. I don't know what they've done with these difficulties. They need changing, obviously. That's obviously the easiest. That should be a 1. Or a 2, I guess. But no, that's realistically a 1. That should be a 3, maybe? That should be a 4? I think Lost World is quite a bit easier than Jurassic Park. Maybe I'd go 4-3-1 so far. Assuming that Jurassic... Some people have said Jurassic World is the hardest, and it's a 5, and that would make sense. Some people have said Jurassic Park is the hardest. It's between these two. People can't seem to decide which is the strongest. So I guess we'll find out. Next time on Chaos Theory, we'll start tomorrow and then pick it up next week. We'll be starting Jurassic World. So if you have been struggling, hopefully I'll be able to help you out with some top tips along the way. Although, based on this video, I'm not sure why it would trust me, quite frankly. Thank you very much for joining me, though. I'll see you lovely folks next time. Cheers much, as always. Bye-bye. Reaching out.